This video discusses overdose prevention for clinicians treating patients with opioids for chronic pain. The opioid overdose death rate in the United States has more than doubled over the last decade, driven by the increased use of opioid pain medications, as well as the use of illicit opioids like heroin and fentanyl. This video highlights key points and strategies for opioid overdose prevention and should not be viewed as guidelines or an exhaustive review of procedures. A key to success for opioid overdose prevention is shared decision-making in patient-centered care, which is a dynamic give-and-take process. Discussing overdose prevention may be uncomfortable, but it is important and represents high-quality care. Four key strategies will be covered in this video: reducing risk for developing an opioid use disorder and reducing the risk of opioid misuse while properly managing chronic pain, identifying overdose risk factors, safety planning, and overdose rescue preparation. The first key strategy is to reduce the risk for developing opioid use disorder and to avoid opioid misuse. It is very important that providers are familiar with evidence-based pain management and opioid prescribing practice guidelines, such as those provided by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Risk reduction strategies include the use of non-opioid medications and non-pharmacological approaches, such as behavioral therapies, as the first lines of treatment. When opioids are used, start with the lowest effective dose and titrate the dose slowly. Document progress toward established therapeutic outcomes and the need for continued treatment with opioids. Plan for the gradual tapering and for careful discontinuation of opioid therapy. Medication misuse may be minimized through the use of treatment agreements, frequent contacts with the patient, and limiting prescriptions to the number of doses needed between appointments. Safe and secure storage of medications, as in a lockbox or high cabinet, to avoid possible diversion and accidental exposure, especially to children. Safe disposal of unused medications. The second key strategy is the identification of patient-specific overdose risk factors, bearing in mind universal precautions in pain management for all patients being treated with opioids for pain. Patients who are prescribed opioids for pain may not understand their risk for overdose, such as a history of overdose, the use of prescribed medications with other opioids or sedatives such as benzodiazepines and alcohol, lowered tolerance after a period of abstinence from opioids, the use of opioids contaminated with fentanyl, the effects of compromised respiratory, renal, and hepatic function. Once the patient's specific overdose risk factors have been identified, a safety plan, the third key strategy, is created to address those factors. Safety planning is an active and collaborative process with the patient, which is updated and modified as circumstances or risk factors change. To begin safety planning, ask the patient how they plan to manage their identified risks. The following are recommended action steps for providers. Encourage family involvement. Co-prescribe naloxone, an opioid antagonist used to reverse opioid overdose. Check the prescription drug monitoring program to review the patient's history of controlled medication fills. Conduct drug testing to assess for the presence of prescribed medications, other controlled medications, or illicit drugs. And coordinate care with any specialty medical and psychiatric providers and pharmacists. Despite education and safety planning, opioid overdose may still occur. We will now discuss the fourth key strategy, overdose rescue preparation. The first step in overdose rescue preparation is to alert the patient to the possibility of overdose and the importance of having someone present who will be able to recognize the signs of overdose and who will respond quickly. The signs of opioid overdose include confusion, slurred speech, drowsiness, slowed or shallow breathing, blue lips or nails, or unresponsiveness. The second step in overdose rescue preparation is to establish a plan for who will administer naloxone and call for help in the event of an overdose. Prompt action is critical. If an overdose is suspected, determine if the patient is responsive. If they are responsive, call 911 and wait with them until help arrives and continue to provide stimulation. If they are not responsive or become unresponsive, administer naloxone, call 911, and wait with them until help arrives. 911 should be called even if there is a response to the first dose of naloxone due to its fairly short half-life and the likelihood of there being other drugs involved. CPR or additional doses of naloxone may be necessary due to a variety of individual factors, discussions of which are beyond the scope of this video. In closing, reducing risk of the development of opioid use disorder or opioid misuse, identifying overdose risk factors, safety planning, and overdose rescue preparation are an essential group of strategies to help reduce the risk of overdose in patients being treated for chronic pain. This video was produced by the National Institute on Drug Abuse and should not be used as guidelines or an exhaustive review of procedures. For additional information, please refer to the hyperlinked resources in the overview of the video featured below.